What's up, everyone? This is Moose, and today I am joined by Hein as we look over CP Gravelpit, this week's UGC Highlander map. This is the final map of the regular season. It is an attack-defend map. We will be playing it with the stopwatch config, just so we get those out of the way. Hein, what do you want to talk about today?
Well, let's talk about offense first, and then we will rotate over to defense. The first thing everyone should know about offense is this little spot right here is not something your medic wants to get in, because there's no way for him to get out, and it's rather embarrassing if you get caught back here with Uber, and then you have to kill yourself. So, just FYI. Also, this hat is awesome, and it's from Clan D9, the steel team that I mentor. I love it, and they're awesome. So, what would you like to start with?
Let's go ahead and do the normal rotation. Now, my understanding is that Gravelpit usually, a lot of teams will give up defending A, really hold down on B. So let's rotate like this is going to be a standard map.
Okay, so the first thing that you want to figure out is, do you want to send everyone to A and definitely get it as soon as you can? Or do you want to split off some to go to B? Do you want to send some to the A cap point and then rotate some through to C to camp their spawn? You have to decide that very quickly. But the main thing is you want to get a good amount of cap time on A, so just in case, you definitely have it and they can't rotate around to stop you. So let's go to A first and we'll kind of go over spots. And you want to watch for this right here for stickies. Anywhere in this whole region, stickies can be hidden. So a really good way to stop that is to get a scout to bonk out or a dead ringer spy, and they can just check, say all clear. They need to check all of these, especially that there. Right here's not such a big one, unless they've got a spy standing over here cloaked. And he says debt, but generally they don't come this far over because then they would be all the way on this side of the map. And generally they don't want to. So when you're capping this, you want as much cap time on it as possible. So your scout is generally that class that you definitely want your 2x on it. You could have your demo jump out here with pain train, so it could be 4x. You could send your sniper, your spy. So if you've got your spy, sniper, and scout, that's 4x. And then that should be enough to stop everything. Maybe have your sniper right here watching this way so they can't poke in. Watching down that way is very important as well, because snipers will wait down there until the cap starts to go, and then they'll just peek out and pop off some heads. The other one, hopefully everyone's learned this, snipers can snipe through that. And it's very easy to do that from over here. All they have to do is line up and wait for you to run into it, so be advised. Another thing on offense is look up. It's a very important thing that sounds really stupid, but it makes sense, because soldiers can stand up there, or right there, or there. I don't think there's really a good one inside, like, that's the closest one, but that's not a really great one, and it's kind of risky. So you've got that down, you've checked everywhere, you're looking for stickies, go there, go right under there, down there. Those are the main spots, so you want to watch out for those. Have somebody, when you're running over from up here, if you go this way, to check this way. Because when you're going like this, you can see through this little window right there. Spooky. And you can make sure that no one's just sitting there camped down, because back in the day, teams would sit right here and just wait, and then they would come out and kill. There's a lot of fun jumps as scout you can do, but I'm not going to try to replicate it because I'll fail at it. You can jump from here onto that window and make sure you go down and around below that, because that'll catch you. Land on there, land up there, then you jump over to there, and then you can get up. It's pretty fun, but it's kind of worthless for the most part. But it's fun. It's something that we do in pubs for fun. So now let's say you sent those three classes here. You got your sniper at A, you got your scout at A, and you got your spy at A. One of the things you want to do is rotate to a place where you can get the most advantage. If you want to push through B with your scout, have him jump back down in through here. That's a big deal because they'll expect him generally to go straight through C and harass the teleporters, or goes through the lower tunnel B, and you can just completely fool him and go back through this way. Word. Then we're good on that. That's A. There's not a whole lot they can do about it unless they devote three or four people, which sometimes they will, just to waste your time as much as possible. So be on the lookout. When you're going through this way, if this is your route, look for sticky spots and weird spots. Like right here, 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 there, on there, down there, here, up there, anywhere that is an easy edge. Look for sticks because they could just have a spy chilling here, or up in here, or down here. There's a lot of places they can hide, so you always want to look out for that cheeky move that is, teamwork. Watch for sticks in that. Then you can go about your business. You can harass. You can kind of do whatever you want to do. Kill the teleporter. Maybe you can leave it up. Maybe take it down. It's kind of dependent on what your team wants to do. I would say take it down. You might just let your spy do it, but that might give it away that your spy is at C, which means he's not obviously pushing B. So you gotta kind of think about it. Think about what you're doing, what the repercussions are for letting them know exactly where you are, where you're pushing from. And we've got your sniper here as well. He probably doesn't want to go back through the B tunnel. And he doesn't want to do the sneaky jump from A up to the spawn, and I'll show that later. But if you're going to push through this way, you got your sniper. He needs to watch for the rafters where soldiers jump. And right here, if he wants to go this way, he's got an easy shot on anything behind the house. If he goes back this side, he's going to need to make sure that he watches all these different little areas. Because once he's here, he's basically overextended to a point where he's gonna get chased down. Right? And you need to coordinate with your team if you're gonna do that. Sorry, now I'm back. That's about it for Sniper. You've got to coordinate really well. And if you do it correctly, you can have a pretty big play going on. Say you don't want to push through B, you want to have everyone go through C. So everyone comes through, you get a few people capping. Maybe you want to have someone at B just to kind of poke around, maybe the demo or the soldier, just to show, hey, we're over here still. And then they could be a little bit of a distraction. So you could have your sniper go out one of these doors, and then the rest of your team goes out the other. So in this instance, we'll say, the sniper's right here. He has his Jurati out. He throws it. It lands right in that area, right about where they always stand. And then, right as they're pissed on, you can have the rest of your team come out right here. Have your demo or your soldier, whoever's not at B, they can bomb down. They can take out the gun. Have your spy come out from lower here and sap the gun, and then everybody pushes in, kills the gun. Merriman has had, and then. You're good to go. You can eat a candy bar on the way. Very delicious. That's just one way you could do it. The other way, which a lot of teams seem to prefer, is to have the sniper go out this way, and maybe Jurati, maybe not, but push out from here and then spam the gun from here, which forces their team to wrangle it up here, and that means people can go from the front side up there, and they can take out anybody they want for the most part. As long as the focus is here and they say, oh, well, they've got the heavy and the demo and the medic and the sniper and all those are up here, this is where they're pushing from, so all eyes are up here. So then when you've got your scout coming through the backside, he's gonna be clipping off people. Probably the sniper will be down in this region. If he's smart, he'll still be watching the region he needs to watch, which is up here. or over there. You never want to give any more ground than you have to. So we'll go over a little bit more about a few different strategies on how to counter these. But if you're going to do this as your offense, you need to make sure that you're actually doing damage. Have someone watch up there, have the soldier jump up there so they can be yet another distraction, get some damage out, shooting straight down. The medic's going to want to retreat, but basically you've cut off his retreat by being over here in the first place. So he's got nowhere to go, so he's going to back off that way. And that's good for you, because that's going to hopefully push him into whoever you have sandwiching their team in. That's always good. And that's a fun jump. I'm glad I didn't screw that one up. But you could have people go this way, your scout mainly, and he can do the jump up here pretty easily. Or you can do this jump. Let me do that over. If you time it right like that, it's a lot easier. I jumped a little too early. But that's it. You can sit here, you can block any kind of jumpers. People don't really realize that Scattergun can stop a jumper completely. And it's fun, also. And then if anything comes long haul, he can go in here, he can kill him really quick. The other one is at this window. Actually, you can do this as a medic with overdose. If you've got a big enough charge, you can jump in the window and jump across to here. And then jump onto here as a medic. It's pretty cool. Practice it if you're gonna do it, because it's not the easiest jump, but it is pretty fun. It's at least fun to do with pubs and crits out. But now that you've sandwiched them in, you've got their medic picked, you clean off the key targets. You kill the gun as quickly as you can, and then you kill that demo man, and then the heavy, and everything after that, they should kind of just fall in suit. If you lose this battle, say they pop Uber, they've got a better Uber. Get out as quickly as you can. If you haven't fully committed and they force your Uber, just put out as much damage as you can. And if you have relatively even Ubers, go ahead and stay with it. As long as their sniper's not down there shooting at your medic, you should be okay. They can't do any immediate 150 health damage that will kill your medic immediately. He should be able to kind of juke and dodge. That being said, you want to watch out for spies curling in behind and the backstab. Kind of typical, but, you know, the heat of the moment, nobody spy checks. Someone should be thinking, hey, we're all looking this way. Let me look this way. Mainly the pyro, you know. It's a good thing for them to do. So, your push failed, but you maybe took down one. Maybe they took down one of yours. Just hit tab and sort out if actually enough people were taken down on either side. If you lose two or three and they're big classes that get your kills, go ahead and back out to C. Redo your push, maintain, cut them off from being fed in here. That's a big deal. If you can kill a few of them and kill a dispenser, or not the dispenser, their teleporter, especially the engineer, if you can kill him and you guys are camping this, they're not going to go anywhere. And if you kill their medic, he's definitely screwed. So remember, you always want to kind of control an area as best you can. This area is also pretty fun because you can set up a level 3 sentry gun to watch their spawn. And it's a pretty big pain to take down unless they put someone off that left side. So you could always just rotate it up here. Stuff like that. Just kind of think out some fun things to do just to cut them off. So that's one possible push that you could do. There's tons of pushes. And your team needs to really know exactly which one you're going to do for which situations. Name it if you want, or if your medic's a main call, just say, hey, we're going to push through C. And that's it. That's all you really got to say. But all those one things led to another. Boom, boom, boom. All the way straight over to B. That's one possible push. Another possible push would be you still send your scout and your sniper and your spy. You get that 4x cap. You get it in a minute, 20 seconds, whatever it takes. And everyone else can just go this way. You can get your demo and your soldier to jump the roof. They can go ahead and put down some cool damage, whatever they can. Hopefully not suicide, but hopefully they'll kill the soldier up top. And everyone else kind of slow pushes in. You don't want to pop unless you have to. Go as Go as slow as you can, kill as much as you can, make sure everybody's getting their buffs. Sniper can come back through this way, he can control this area. They're not really going to get a whole lot on him because he's way back here. If they focus him and you guys are right here, that's free. That's a free kill. And you might lose your sniper, but more than likely, it's worse for them to lose anyone. And it's probably going to be their soldier thinking it's an easy kill from up there. And losing soldier on this is huge. Losing roof is bad. That's a very, very bad thing. It's good for you on offense, of course. So when you're pushing in, you need to know where the gun is. That's the first thing your spy should tell you. If you're all hanging out back here, or probably back here, maybe, just be like, you're just waiting. If the gun is on the front of the house, which is what we call this, I guess I'll go over some names. This is considered the front of the house. This is considered the back or the fence. That's the rock. This is just kind of upper C area. This hall is called long hall because, it's long. You got a long view on it. This one is called short hall for obvious reasons. And this is tunnel. What some teams will do, and what we've kind of played with a few seasons ago, is just numbering them and go clockwise. You've got one, two, three, four, and then up here is five. You don't really have to do that for A, so don't bother doing that because you're probably not going to play defense on it. We'll go over a defense fold for A just for kicks and giggles. Some teams can do it. It's more difficult, so most don't. But if you go with that route, that's very easy. Coming in two, coming in three, they're coming in five, or four and five, but they're flanking one, etc. Just make sure everyone knows exactly what you're calling. So you're good. You're good to go on that one. Say, you push out one. You've got your soldier on the roof. You've got your spy going back that far side over that way. And you've got your sniper up on that door right there. You've got a pretty good setup going right now where you've got your soldier dropping down some damage. You've got your spy saying, I'm gonna sap in three, two, one. At this 1 second call, you go ahead and come around the corner. You get your distraction looking this way. And then the spy can hopefully get a backstab on anyone. Anyone is good. But the keys are generally medic, engineer, demo. Those are your big ones. Let your soldier focus down the gun and the heavy. Your demo focuses down the gun. You just go from there. It's all about DM. Once you get your push established, then you have to just commit to it and you go. You kill as many as you can. Your medic at this point is all in. There's really nothing he can do except run all the way back out here, and we'll count it out. Actually, we won't because it'll take too long. It's about 15, 20 seconds for him to get all the way to A. You might as well just kill yourself. That sounds really dumb, but it's going to take you much, much longer to go all the way around. You're not charging anyone anyways. And by that time, you have to go to A, and you don't always want to go to A. So kill yourself when your team dies, and you'll spawn with your team. You'll be building probably faster than you would otherwise. So you gotta kind of think about it. Don't always think about stats. It's okay to die, especially if you win. But that's why people don't look straight at stats, because they're usually wrong. So that's another push. That's two completely different pushes. Let's go over a third one, just for more kicks and giggles. Let's say you've got your sniper is over here. He's on the right hall. I'm spending a lot of time on B because this is usually where strategies falter. They completely just destroys, everyone gets frustrated. So hopefully if I can give a lot of different options that are fairly simple to do, hopefully that will help. And it'll make it where it's not as frustrating, because it's gonna be frustrating. Even on a high level, sixes, platinum, invite level, whatever, it's not an easy map. Don't think, hey, my team sucks at this map. Pretty much everyone sucks at this map. There's very few teams that are just amazing at it against every team, so don't get disheartened. Just focus. Just, play your cards, what you have. So let's say you've got your scout is over here. He's gonna bonk out. He's with the sniper, so maybe he can draw some fire into the sniper. Baiting is always really fun. So he might get a pick there. And one pick will generally let you in. And that's all for this hall. Everyone else goes through this hall right here. The low hall. So they'll come out. You can see right through there. Is there sniper up there? Is he watching? No, he's not. Okay, we'll go ahead and run through. Your medic can kind of hide out here until you're ready to push. He needs to be doing this section right here. Because this is where soldiers dive. This is just the easiest place to die. It's the Badlands of the Gravel Pit. Watch out in all of that region up there for snipers. In the house, snipers are around, and over there especially. As long as you're doing that and you're calling out where the sniper is, you're safe and you're okay. If you can't get out in the first place, generally you want to wait until you know where the sniper is, because you don't want to drop to that. You can avoid bombing soldiers and stickies and all that kind of stuff, especially right there, if you get communication, but you can't always. So plan what you can, don't worry about what you can't. So you're pushing out here, they call the gun is up here, so you rotate right here with your heavy. Your heavy just takes it down as quickly as possible. Watch for up there. Hopefully your soldier is up there by now. You want to push with your whole team. You don't want to bleed in one by one. So these pushes all maintain. You've got at least six or seven of your team, and the other three are kind of coming in behind you. Never push in with two or three. You're going to die. You're not going to do anything of worth. Unless they've got tons down, which more than likely won't happen. So don't plan on it. So you're pushing this way. The gun's right here. You take it down without even dropping an Uber. But they have a sniper that just peeked out of there, and your medic dies. Don't just run around with your head cut off like a chicken. Go ahead and push the point, get some time on it with your heavy. He can kind of put out damage. Your demo man can still do work. He can peek the corner. He can take it down from in here without even being seen. The other thing you could do is if the gun is back here, you can try to take it down from over here with a direct hit. Stickies over the roof, whatever, just lots and lots of spam. The other way is just come all the way around, pop Uber immediately on it, kill the pyro before he can waste your Uber, take down the gun, and then they're probably going to pop at that point, or they might pop early just to try to block yours, which could be up here just to completely keep you away from the gun, because this is one of those, it's kind of like payload, where you want to force their Uber before they ever get to your gun. So be mindful of that when you're popping, and make it where you choose where you pop on offense. You never want them to be able to dictate where you pop, because if that happens, you're not going to have a very successful push. I also would not recommend pushing out of this door if they have a soldier up there. It's a very easy point for him just to keep spamming down. He's going to call it out to his team, and they're going to have enough time that they can rotate forward and block yours out and just completely ruin yours. And they'll kill as many as they can. Your only outlet as a medic is to back up here, which takes you out of the fight. Maybe you'll take two or three people with you, but with Ubers only taking 40 seconds to build, and if they kill three or four of your guys, that's their advantage. You might still have Uber, but you have nobody to push in with. This is one of those kind of maps. So just remember that. Be aggressive. It's okay to be aggressive, but don't be too aggressive. Don't force their Uber, or don't pop your Uber here when they're back here. Because what they're going to do is they're going to have their pyro tank you back. It's going to air blast, completely waste yours, and then they're going to come in force and destroy you. So if you're going to try to be aggressive like that, make sure it works. Don't flub it up, or you'll lose the point, and you'll have to just get out. Which means they could take B, they could block you in the spawns, etc. But that's basically it. That was three or four different ways to push B. Is that right, Moose?
Yeah, that sounds just about right. I think it was three.
Okay, cool. Use variations. Don't use exactly that. We got one push from here, One push from there, one push from both doors. I don't really recommend pushing tunnel, because it generally doesn't work. So each door can have its own main push. There's different provisos for each one, though. And I think we went over all those, so... The only outlier is the spy. And we'll go over the spy once we get to that region. Now is... Okay, let's say you've got B. You wiped their team. They've only got two or three people up. Their engineer's up. Their medic's up. He's at 50% Uber. You're at 40% Uber. He's got some kind of advantage. And the points only capped a sliver. You've got 2x on it. Will they push in? Maybe. Will they stay back? Maybe. You never know. But you want to make it as hard for them as possible to push in. So let's say you've got your demo man, because that makes it really easy. Demo man and sniper. And then you got the scout on the point, your medics somewhere, whatever. Medics don't matter, you know, they're bad. But you want to have your sticky man, he's sticking up this area, and then your sniper man's way back there. He's blocking off what he can. Maybe he can chill right here. He can watch this door with your demo man. He can watch that door with his sniper rifle. The other way is for your sniper to jump in this window, do a half crouch, and if you do it right, you can still get your 1x, and he can still sit here and snipe. These are very basic tricks. I'm pretty sure everyone's known these for the last 5 years from pubs, but you know, some people aren't as versed. So that's basically how you hold B as best you can. You don't want to be too far up. You can have your heavy here. If you're all up, you might as well go ahead and push into C, but if they're all up also, you definitely want to get B. You don't want to abandon it and just leave your scout or sniper or something, and then they get backstabbed. Then you don't have B, and your push is probably going to not work out because you've got your attention split. So don't count your chicken before they hatch, you know. It's one of those kind of things. But when you're pushing through here, let's say you've got B, they held off, whatever. You gotta make sure you're checking all of this area for little sticky traps. They're all nice and annoying, but they work. The other way to push is this side. And as you go back out, you'll know there's stickies there, and there, 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 there. Those are the main ones. Those are the big ones. So decide as a team how you're going to push, because you obviously, you want to split as much as you can. If they're all up, you have to change how you're going to push. If you know certain classes are down, you can just barrel through, like their sniper's down, their demo's down, go on through, doesn't matter. You can Uber, you can kill the gun easy, go straight to the point. Your medic pretty much always wants to just run straight up as best he can, because he wants to catch the soldier in the demo if they jump up there. He'll be able to walk it up, and the heavy will hopefully walk up behind him, blocking anybody that's coming, and you get in a safe spot. Generally, when I'm playing as medic, I'll stand right here and peek really fast back and forth, because if I see anyone peek, I'm gone. But I can call it and say, hey, they're there. And generally, snipers don't sit down there and fully charge their shot and then just slowly creep out. That generally doesn't work. They're gonna run out and they're gonna try to throw Girardi or whatever, but unless you have really slow reaction time, you should be able to at least strafe back before they kill you. Either side, you need to be watching. You gotta watch for jumpers. Make sure no one sneaks up on you. Like, a soldier from down there is really bad. But walk it up. That's this push. That's basically... I'm making it sound really simple and easy. It's not, but if you do it with the right people, it is easy. Let's say they've got their gun right here. They've got their heavy and pyro up there. They've got their soldier up there as well, whatever. Their medic's up there. You've got a pretty bad situation going on here. So the first thing you want to do, in this situation, I would probably go out of this door. More than likely, pop your Uber, have your soldier just jump straight up, probably get air blasted back, but big deal. Have your demo shoot the gun down, have the heavy just putting out damage up there, mainly focused in the pyro, because you want the pyro dead. Someone's got to come out of this door, probably the sniper, somebody like that, picking off all the people that are looking down at you guys down there. And that's good. That's good for you. You want to do that. You can have your scout bonk out here. He can do this little jump right here, which is really awesome. I'm glad I hit that. And he can come in from behind. You probably don't want to get on the point immediately because that really loud sound is really telling that, hey, someone jumped. They're going to all turn around. So if you do the jump, just stand here and shoot. Go up here, shoot down on them. There's a lot of things you can do as scout. This is a huge scout map, and it's a lot of fun to play as long as you understand your role. Your role is not get 50 billion kills. It's to give a lot of comms. It's to sneak around and flank, kill who you can, and then run away. Just be a little pest. Normally what the spy does is this almost every single map. So now the scout gets to do it, and it can be very beneficial, but more than likely, you're not going to be with your medic a whole lot. So be independent. Make sure you know where all the healths are in the map, in this area. You've got all these little ones, and then you're basically starved on this side. If they've got in the house, you can always take this one. And then there's the one back there. And the one I just ran past. All those are very small, but they're enough to keep you alive. The big ones are all in areas that you have to run away, like down on B, under A. There's really none in here because that would be too easy for the defense. But I digress, kind of getting off point, kind of. So you've got your split going. Your soldier jump, your demo's down here putting out sticky spam. He's killed the gun, heavy's going up. You force their Uber as well with the soldier, which is good. You might also, just thinking out loud, you could split your force even more. Have your soldier and demo come out this door. Demo comes out this door, spams up there. Have your soldier jump up a delayed push, and have your heavy come out this door right here, spinning, take down the gun as quick as you can. Your medic rotates forward, he splits the Uber on him, turns around, lets the soldier jump, scout comes in the other way. There's a lot of stuff you can do. Just make sure you're thinking about the process of everything that you're going through. Try not to drop anyone. If your heavy dies right here, that's his own fault for being dumb. He needs to wait until you're ready to go out. And he needs to wait until they're preoccupied. He can even sit here and just spam and shoot and shoot. And more than likely, the engineers get a Wrangler because apparently every engineer thinks that's really awesome. But the bad thing about that is he's only going to probably be shooting one person at a time. So he might want to just wait until it's wrangled, let the sniper get a few shots on the engineer, make him back out, and then go for it. Not too hard, especially if you have a really smart heavy. And if he knows he can't get it, he can back out here. It's not that bad. You can always back out of a situation on this map, especially with these kind of doors, because there's always places that you can hide. It's not just a sheer wall right here. You can back out, you can get in the pockets, you can go back here. It's a lot of cool stuff you can do with this map. It's a really good map. It's very frustrating though, if everyone doesn't listen or your comms aren't good, you know, practice. So that's the push from B for the most part. You just have to bum rush it in whatever manner you want. Coordinate your classes over here so that halfway through your push, they can go ahead and come around through the tunnel and come up around, or if they're dead, whoever's over here can just go straight out, depending on the class, of course. So let's go over this push from here. A lot of times teleporters will be in here. You can surround yourself. All nine people can be here if you want to do that push and split between this way and this way. It'll be difficult. I'm not going to say it's easy, but if their gun's way back there, that's a lot farther that it has to travel to get you. You can have your scout jump here, bonking over. And then the defense knows, hey, he's coming up below. And they will probably turn around. At least one or two of them will look back this way. And then you can have your jumpers come in. They can file in from this side. This is a really close jump, a lot of teams will use this because for the most part the gun's going to be way over there. If they come in from right here, they really can't get hit with it. So they're going to Uber in their heavy, they're going to Uber in their soldier and their demo man. So they're going to all be on that side. If you're going to coordinate this push, everyone needs to go the other way. Your pyro should probably go down low and snake up through, scout the other side. Spy should go for the engineer. And that's basically how you push from this side. Thoughts?
That sounds pretty good to me. You were talking about numbering doors on B, 1 through 5. That works here, too. I'm floating out in camera. But from the top of the point on top of C, you can do the same thing. Number them clockwise, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So if you want to coordinate a push, you can say, okay, push out of 3 and 4. And hopefully your team will know what to do at that point. Or, okay, heavy out of 1. Soldier demo out of 2, like you were saying earlier, and basically achieve the same effect. As far as pushes go, there's really not much else to say. I mean, those are the two basic pushes that you do. The only thing I would go over again is spy. Maybe have the spy in the background trying to harass, trying to get them to turn around, like you were saying, having the soldier do. Or the scout dude, just trying to get them to turn around. If you can do that with the spy as well, that just helps your push out just that much more.
Agreed. There's a lot of other things that I could go over, but, you know, find some things out for yourself that are really fun. We'll just go over defense. How does that sound?
Sounds good to me, dude. You want to start with A again? Just kind of go over... There's not much to go over. Sure. A is usually pretty neglected as far as defense goes, but there are options there, and teams on offense should be ready for those.
All right, we'll go over some easy hiding spots. This is if they don't defend and they just put a few people in here. I've seen scouts that will sit here. They'll wait. And they'll call, and then they'll just chase whoever comes out. Usually it is the other scout. The other hiding spot is right here, and wait. Or here, and wait. We kind of went over this one. That's really easy to see, but these generally aren't. So just train yourself to look in those areas as well. Look up there. You can stand up there. Maybe don't do it the first round, and do it the second, or don't do it, or do it the first and don't do it the second. It's generally better to not do it one round, and then the next time they won't expect it again. That's not a hiding spot, I just wanted to jump up here. That's about it, really. Spy, sniper, scout generally are the only ones that ever come over here. Because you don't want to abandon B. That's your big hold. That's your big stronghold. So if you lose B first, say they all charge B and you got only two or three people here, more than likely you're looking for a really fast time on offense if you go for that route. Because if it fails, you're failed. That's about it. You can only hope that these guys will get their point. You don't have to worry about it. And then your push to B is not worthless, basically, because that's all dead time. While this one's capping, it's kind of dead time. So on a defensive manner, you want to block them as much as you can. You can hide right here. A lot of the times teams won't push out there, but if you can stand right about here where they can't see, you see them pushing out, you can instantly back out once they're behind that house, and you can rotate over and say you just kind of stand here. Or figure out where the shadows are, because you don't want a shadow to go through the wall and screw you over. But hide as best you can. And that's fine. It works. Getting an easy pick on one scout, if they only send one through and you kill him, they're not going to get A for another 2 or 3 minutes. Because they have to decide, hey, he died there. Do we wait? What do we do? I don't know. Let's... So it's good to have a good one-on-one scout on your team as best you can. That being said, that's it. That's it for A. If that's all you're going to do, GG, you're done. Another thing you could do is hold A. It's very uncommon, but it can work. Not often, but it can. If they push B really hard and you all die, or you don't die, but you just back out, come to A, block A. There's gun spots everywhere. You can jump over here, put a level 3 up here. It can watch all the doors, you can wrangle it. Another starter spot, if you start in A, put your dispenser here, build your level 3 here. This is a big thing back in 6's 4 years ago, give or take. They build a gun here, maybe build a little shitty gun there, and then the second NG would just leave and go back to spawn. Once his gun died, he'd rotate back to the scout class. It's kind of an Iron Man setup, but not really. Iron Man being you try to defend both. So if you're going to do that, you need to have your heavy and medic in a spot where they can't get sniped. Soldier probably on one of these roofs. Demo sticking up one side or the other. You probably want to split your heavy classes. And just roam free. Watch out for spies, watch out for snipers. Everything else, you should be able to stop with your pyro or your heavy classes. They can jump out really quickly. And it can be very painful to push in on this. If they've got a good sniper that's standing right here or over here, you can lock this point down. If anybody says you can't, they probably haven't faced a team that knows how to hold it. A lot of teams just don't know how to hold it. So be ready for that. If you can block them off at B and you lose A, just expect to hold. They're not going to go straight to C unless they're dumb. They still need to hold another point. So that's a few options for this point. Another gun spot that I've seen is right here. It's kind of annoying. Just because you have to peek all the way around it to get it from here or from below the house. So just tool around with it if you want to go that route. It's very risky, but it could be very rewarding. Or do a split.
My last spot, I don't think you've covered this yet. The entrance of the tunnel to B, a sniper can jump up here right on this sign and snipe right into the spawn door. He can see pretty far in there, so usually... and you'll see this a lot in 6's cast nowadays, is that medics will not come out of spawn immediately to go rush A. And I think that that's pretty much standard. Usually they'll sit in spawn, or they'll sit back here in this corner. But you don't want your medic dropping immediately, because that'll definitely ruin your uber chances, and then the defense can come uber in, destroy whatever's trying to cap whatever point. And so yeah, like standing from this sign, basically, I can pretty much see where Hein just ran in. That's something you want to watch out for. Maybe send your spy or scout bonked out, like you said earlier, not only to check stickies, but to check and make sure the sniper is not sitting right here getting ready to pick someone big. And look
that's
at you
the
being
joke.
All fancy with your jumps.
As long as you can get up without it forcing you to crouch, you're okay. And the way I do it is once I'm on there, obviously you're standing right here, you hold forward and right and just curl in, because the back left side of you is kind of what kind of pulls in the weight. So you got to curl it in. You can't generally just jump straight in, because usually people mess it up. Best of luck if you want to try that jump, because it's not very fun when you don't get it. Defense. Let's go defensive B. This is the big one. This is what everybody holds. So we'll do some generics here as well. Gun spots. One of the old school gun spots. Dispenser here, level 3 here. This is what everyone ran for a long time. Some people run level 3s from here, wrangle it in. A lot of people will do, I think there's a burn spot in this area. I think it was Enigma kind of started this hold, which pretty cool. It works out. You get your gun here, it can watch those doors, and then they have to rotate all the way around the house to get it. You get your pyro here, you get your heavy, you waste their uber, they can't get the gun. You're golden. All you have to do is watch out for here and back there for the spies. Another big one for spies. We'll go over that because spies are very annoying on this map. If you watch Season 5 of UGC, Looking Handsome versus Lonely Hearts, DL Man, their spy, was amazing. He would just stand right here, he would wait, he'd uncloak, and then just stab me in the top of the head. He did it twice. It's really annoying. I apparently didn't learn from it. Half the time, we would be standing back here, just hanging out. They'd say, okay, a spy's coming in. We'd rotate here, and then I'd be dead. It happens. So watch out for that. It's very tricky, and it's very easy for good spies. That's about it for spies. It's very hard to spy this map, I think. There's a lot of spies that say it's really easy, but usually they're playing against very unaware teams. As a medic, you always want to be right in this line as much as possible. The reason I say this is because, A, you can't get backstabbed, obviously, and you can watch your heavies back. What you need from your team is you need someone watching up at C area to say, hey, they're coming in from this way, so designate a spy or a scout or your sniper or whatever you want to kind of range in that area. Or soldier, probably not soldier, but whoever you can spare that can just kind of camp out and watch. And you want someone always watching here. It will be the life or death of your hold if your sniper dies and their sniper has full range. You don't want that. So you need very quick comms for snipers at this door, snipers at 2, snipers at 1, snipers at 4, whatever. Make sure you call it quick, because your medic needs to know very quickly. If they're at long, he needs to go this way. If they're up there, he needs to go this way. Or this way. Kind of whatever. But they might just be putting their sniper in a spot where you're backing into what they're pushing. So if they do that, and you recognize it early enough, say, someone is at C, and they say, hey, they're all pushing C, but then your sniper's over here and says, hey, they're pushing long, you know they're going to sandwich you. So you need to be ready for their Uber. And one thing you can do to do that is, if you hear where their medic is, push into them. Say they've got their medic up here in this room, push into them until they pop. Don't die, hopefully, because you don't want to pop first, generally. You can wait right here and just wait for them until they come around, kill a few, and then they'll pop, and then you can counter pop, keep your pyro with you, and force theirs back. It's very cool stuff. And that kills a lot of pushes right there. Just ruining their uber fast enough, it'll make or break their push, obviously. Because, you know, it's hard to push in without an uber. And teams that try generally fail. I know we've tried it a few times in former seasons. It's very difficult unless they have certain classes that are dead. You always want to have a soldier or a demo man up on the house, maybe a scout. There's a lot of different places your scout could go, so house is probably not where he should go. But you know, every team's different. A lot of strategies work. You can have your scout roam up through the spawn area. He can be up here and just wait. And say, oh, they're pushing this way, and then he leaves. GG. That's B. It's really not that complicated. If they push short haul, make sure you get a lot of spam on it. Rotate forward, as I was talking about. You could rotate just right here. You're not gonna get sniped. You can force their Uber from here. Your soldier's up there spamming down. Your heavy's here. You're just doing tons of damage. They're gonna rotate through. It's basically running them through a gauntlet before they get to the prize, which is the gun. And if they don't have enough, or you kill enough of them, that's great. Don't shoot the guy that's getting healed. Shoot everyone else, because at that point, the medic is focused on exactly what he wants to do, and he's pushing in the person he needs. So if you hurt everyone else, that's going to cause two situations. A, everyone else is going to get hurt or die, and that's going to leave him and whoever he's Ubering. Or he's going to turn around and try to heal up those people, slowing down their push, and then you can focus down whoever he was healing. It works out. And that's B. It's difficult. It's difficult to do. In theory, it's easy. Make sure you can get some good DM out there. Practice, warm up, Don't go into it cold. As long as everyone knows what they're doing with communication, it's much easier than if it's mayhem. Rotating through gun spots. Gun spot here is good. I've seen gun spots here that work. Level threes here can work as long as you've got someone up there blocking, like the pyro, something like that. Gun spot here, or here, or here. All are very good. This one, adversely to that side over there, will work. If they know you've got a gun over there, one push and there's fails, they might try to push an Uber on that side, and if you move your gun over here to trick them, good game. They wasted their Uber, and you've still got your gun that you can control this path with. Sniper spots, not a whole lot, but what there is are very annoying. You can control from here, you can control from here, here, here. That's not my spawn, so I can't go through. Backing up. So this one is a little bit weaker. A lot of snipers don't come from here because you don't have as big a sight lines, but it's more of a surprise for people coming out that door if you're fully charged. You can also rotate this way and shoot under there. If they've got their sniper trying to shoot through these boards to get your engineer or dispenser or something, you might want to consider putting your dispenser up here. And then your team just knows. So those are your gun spots for the most part. There's a lot of options. You can run minis on this if you want. Certain teams can run it very well. The other one is this jump right here. To get back here, you can put a dispenser here, a teleporter here. As long as everybody knows about the jump, you can do it. The other way to get there, which is a little harder because this is really low, is go right on the edge here and then rotate around. It's a lot harder for the slower classes, but it's pretty easy for Scout. But Scout can double jump, so it doesn't matter. Tele here is pretty smart, it's pretty protected. Heavy weapons guy standing up here is pretty good. Or if your heavy's down there and your medic's up here, that'll block him from getting sniped. But generally, heavies don't just stand here, they'll go both sides, so you run the risk of not being able to heal people. So be advised on that as well. Let's go over some different pushes. So let's say they're pushing down and they're doing that push that we did on this side. You want to have your pyro force them back, air blast all the way down. If you see that their combo is just running straight up, they killed the gun, your pyro needs to come this way and wait and see which way they go, because he can just air blast them off. If luck strikes him and they come up and go right here, he can just air blast them straight off. That's great. That's key. And then you can cut him off and kill whoever's coming up. Or if you see him coming up, you can just do this action right here and air blast him back as well. Pyro is very important on this point. This is where medics want to heal your pyro up a lot more. If you generally don't anywhere else, this is where you want to. Heavy weapons guy can stop all jumpers regardless if they're Ubered or not. He can just blast him back down. You want to stop that initial jump as much as possible. The gun will go down regardless of what happens, so just try to keep it up as long as you can, but mainly you want to focus on this right here. Your engineer can die, your gun can die, your medic, your heavy, your pyro, your demo probably shouldn't. It's a bad thing if they do. And your scout could go crazy flanking. It's a really good one. If you say, hey, their sniper's at three, your scout can go through five, he can rotate straight in on him, he can go through the bottom. You always want that sniper dead. Just form a plan for exactly what you want. Each door you can have a different plan for. Whoever's at B, say you've got someone at B, you've got someone at A. They say, hey, they're coming in at A. And you know, okay, they could do either this push or this push. So you have plans for both. If they push in this side, you reflect, whatever, kind of the same thing as over here. You don't want them up here as best as possible. You can pop your Uber. You want to pop your Uber when you want to pop it. It's just like when you're on offense. You never want them to force yours. If they're jumping up from here, you can generally easily stop those. So try as best you can, air blast them back off. Don't let them just walk it up. Drop down in front of them, block them, just hold them off for as long as you can. Don't suicide to drop, of course. So that's pretty much it. I could go on much, much longer, but I think we're already a little bit past 50 minutes, so that's about the attention span of everybody. That's all I'll do for now. There's a few different things I'm not going to go over because they're too awesome. And maybe we'll get a cast and you'll see.
Sounds good to me, dude. Same as usual. You've hit us up in the forums, comments, message us. We're always around. Good luck this week to everyone. This will pretty much determine playoff seeding. If you guys are one of the top 16-bound teams for playoffs in your division, congratulations and good luck to you guys in the playoffs. Otherwise, you know, we're always around. Hit us up. This is Moose signing out.